everybody. This is Jan from Jan's Art. And today we're going to have a go at doing a caricature, which is another little thing that I do. So I'm starting off with some white card. I've got a 2B pencil. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to start getting an outline of this face. Now I'm doing this for a friend, an old police friend, so this is a pro bono. And he's asked me to draw this young lady. So all I'm doing is I'm just looking where all the main parts are, and I'm just putting in some guidelines. A cheeky little smile, so I've got to put that cheeky little smile in. Well, I think she's got a cheeky little smile just by looking at the reference that I have. Okay, let's just work on this chin, bring it up here. That's it. Little bit of highlight to the nose. Let's get some nostrils in. Here she's got really defined brows, so I've got to put them in. Top of the head. Now she's got the most amazing hair you've ever seen. I'll show you what I mean. You've got curly bits like this, look. And I'm just coming down the face, and they go into the face. There we go, just like that. She's got others. See what I mean? She's got that kind of hair. So we've got to put that. Got to be drawn individually. It's the only way you can do this. Maybe bring this up a bit more, see that's better. To give them a little bit of highlight, see? She's got very dark eyes. Just get those nostrils in. I'm going to start using these graphic line markers. They're all different thicknesses. I'm also going to have a go. I didn't find it. Can you find it? Is it anywhere to be seen? Yes! I've got a mango paintbrush. See? And we'll try that. Let's see what happens. And I've got some Kumi ink. City has. And every cheese, look. It's not Kumi, it's Sumi ink. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start off with my smallest, 0.5. And I just want to show you how I ink in. Let's just get some of that in there. A few little highlights. Now this lady, she's got very dark eyes. Oh, they're in the shade. So let's just put them in there. Let's just get the nostrils in. This is still in the early stages. Bit of a smile. She's got amazing hair, and this is what I want to put into the drawing. This little sketch, ink sketch that I'm doing. Shadows under the eyes, so I'm just going to put them in. There we go. Just ink them in. They're very straight and very angular, so that's what I want to do. I want to get them in like that. Put them highlights in there. Right. I've got a 2B pencil here, and all I'm going to do is I'm just going to quickly put some skin tone in. See, I'm just going over, trying to leave the whites of the eyes white. It doesn't matter if I go over them, I can always rub them out. It's a little highlight. I'm just adding a little bit of skin tone to our skin that I can see. There we go. A little teeny weeny little bit of skin tone. Okay. Pencil, and let's just shade in a little bit harder. on the top lip, see? Maybe a little bit softer for the bottom lip. This is where the highlight is. So it's not as dark as the top lip, just a little bit lighter, see? Now I've got a little bit of shadow under the nose, so I might as well just put that in there, see? And then immediately those eyes just pop out. The nose, sorry, just pops off. Just colouring in the pupils of the eyes. Just want to get a, maybe a number one. Just put these eyes in. There we go, and I'm just making the around the edges of the pupils a bit thicker, just to make them stand out, you see. And now she has really dark eyes. So I want to add them and darkness in. She has it here as well. So I'm just hatching across the eyes. There we go. Just so we can start to get that. Right, I'm going to have a go with this Sumi ink. So, I've got this, as you can see on the label, this Japanese little manga brush. So I'm just going to get some ink on it. Now, Sumi ink dries really, really fast. So, let's just put in. And you can see the lines that I can do are so fine, look. See? But because it's a brush, it gives you a lovely line look, see? Now it has to be noted that a steady hand does help. There we go. I'm just getting that in. I want to get these curls in, see? There we go. It gives you some lovely thicknesses, look at that. See what I mean? It's really helping define unique hairstyle she's got. I love it a bit. There we go. And I'm just letting the brush find what it wants to find. Do some more up here, look. I'm just letting the ships. Just flow, I'm not going to force it. It gives you a lovely tape at age. Look at that. First time I've tried these brushes, and I must admit, they are lovely. I mean, it really does give you some control, see? Look at that. Hey, it's just sticking up this. Eye up here, okay. See? I was quite surprised. I tried this yesterday, just a few little sketches, and well, it was sketchy. Just with a Sumi brush, it really is the details you can get. Very fine, and it dries. Oh. Not too wet. Yeah, but it does dry fast. Just lets you do these lovely curls. Look at that. Just look at them curls. And let's just do a something along the top there. I love that, the flow of this brush. Look at that. I'm going to try a long stroke here. Oh yes, I do like this. I know I should have started on the other side, but I was just carried away with this brush. This is all dry, so I can lean my hand on there, it's not a problem. These brushes are brilliant. They are a little bit expensive, but they're beautifully made. They really do think they're value for money. This brush here that I bought yesterday, I picked up for 17 quid. Now that might be a lot for a brush, you're thinking, but it's very thin, it's very accurate. If you've got the patience, oh, I just love it. The bits, look at this. just great for getting them. This is why probably manga artists like this like to use these brushes, because you can get a feeling in the stroke, and you can go very thick or very thin, and it's just a little bit of pressure. Look, it's all it's taken. Or you can go very thin. It's probably best, I would say, to use this when your paper is flat. I've got this paper at an angle for the filming. So I'm having to take a little bit of care. But it's working. When you hold the brush closer to the nib, I find you get more control than I do when it's too far away. So that's something to bear in mind when you're using these brushes. They really give you a beautiful line. Look at this. You can really, really go to town on this. Let's just work on these. Perfect. Right, I just wanted to find the jaw and the chin. With a thicker line, that's it. Now, let's try something. She's wearing a black top, so let's just paint this in. Just going around the white bits, look. Oh, it fills in beautifully. Look, you can go really thick. And it is jet black. Look at that. That's because I'm just using the ink straight out the bottle. It's not diluted. There we go. Start putting in some of these darks in here. Look, she's got some dark areas in the curls. Let's start to bring out maybe the depth and thickness of the hair, you know. That's better. And just in a few places, look. Just strengthening the bits in between the hair, look. See? Maybe. Just there. It's lovely. It gives you so much control over the where you're putting in this black. There we go. See, I'm starting on the wrong side again. I just don't care. Right, what I'm going to do is just outline. That's better. See? Cool. And it just pulls them strands and it just makes them a little bit thicker where I want them to be. There you go, see? Let's just bring. For darkening the eyes, look. You know what? I reckon I could have painted this whole thing with just this paintbrush. Look at the thickness there you get. That's it. Bit more in the nostrils. This is a really cool brush. Do you know what? I think this is going to be my favourite brush. Honestly. I just look at it. Just great for tidying up. See. Right, we just want to put in a... maybe a thicker edge. There we go, look at that. Maybe carry on this edge. Wow. Well, I hope my mate appreciates what I'm doing for him here. He still owes me a cup of tea from the police canteen when we used to come in for a cup of tea. And he'll always say, well, you know, I haven't got any change. And it was Muggins here who had to buy the teas. See, we never forget us pools. There we go, look at that. Maybe just look. Oh, wow. This is how I like to. Just blend in the black, coming in a little bit like that, you see? There we go. This has been one of the most enjoyable caricatures that I've done. Normally I'm a lot quicker, but I'm just enjoying this pen, this paintbrush. Just look at the lines you can get. But these manga artists have so much fun when they're painting the characters. A little bit of a line there. Right, I think that's enough for the brush. The thing about these brushes, you have to clean them when you're finished with them. So just to check the lid, the very fine point that you get to them. That's it. Shading this in, because we've got a little bit of shadow here, look, that I can just put in. That's it. Maybe just bring it out just a little bit more. That's it, this is just gonna add to the 3D effect that I wanna get with the face just coming out. That's it. Just using my finger as a bit of a better edge. That's it. Let's just add a little bit more to this. Let's just add some highlight to that nose. It's what I call the Rudolph nose, where you just emphasize it by shading around the highlight, you see? And just bringing in up here, look, like this. Maybe shading these shadows in, look here. Gorgeous. Shading these whites of the eyes on this side, just make the corners, that's it, and just bring in the cheeks, see, just a little bit of shading, just a bit of cross hatching, you see, there we go, and let's just join this mouth to them creases. There we go. So a bit more shading on the chin, on the cheeks, bringing it up to form a shape of the nose, a bit under the sides where the hair is, see, just helps to find that lightness, and then just go right across the forehead, join the other side, and there you are, see? Right, all I've got to do now is put my signature on it. And then it's all done. Should have used a brush for this. But I'm getting what I want. And there, the finished article. Well, I hope you've enjoyed watching this as much as I've enjoyed drawing it. So thanks for watching, everybody. Happy painting, drawing, sketching, or whatever makes you happy. Bye for now.